Warming up, I like to. Yeah, I think we talked about this earlier. The question that
we did.
Just, we all have little personal routines. But I like to sing, specifically Sam Smith songs because he's ridiculously high range, and I just sing songs that Michael Jackson things are like go up there and go all up and down the range. The scale as loud and proud as I can in my car in the shower, and drink a lot of water. I mean, that's the morning routine though. I get up at 6 a.m. and I'm like annoying my neighbors and roommates and stuff, no doubt. Anyway.
I've yet to hear you.
Okay, good. But so that's my personal kind of routine. I'll try to do yoga, hit the gym, try to get frosty before if it's a big scene or I know it's a yelling thing. But the difficulty I would say, and I'll toss this to my comrades, is that oftentimes we don't know with simuldub and things what's coming. So we could get ready to walk into a scene that's going to be full of yelling. And I just did my normal, okay, let's go. It's like, all right, Rico, you're going to be yelling for 2 hours straight because you're in a fight. And I'm like, oh, man. All right, well, here we go.
I go in to record all the time, and I have no idea until I step into the booth what I'm recording for. Sometimes they do not tell you in advance. So it's kind of just getting into the mindset of I'm ready for anything, throw me what you got, and I'll work with it. And then there are certain things that, like singing in the car, like you were saying, that will help with whatever it is you're going to be doing, as long as it's voiceover, staying hydrated. I was talking about earlier how I have to consciously remind myself to drink water before a recording session because I generally am kind of bad about staying hydrated, which is very important when it comes to doing voiceover, obviously. I know. Thank you for the reminder. So I try to drink a lot before a session. Singing in the car along with the radio.
Yes, I think that's probably going to be most of our answers is singing or doing some kind of your typical vocal exercises that you learned in choir, basically.
Right,
exactly. Going up the scale and up and down.
Just getting
and
warmed up.
A couple of us are based in Austin, and most of the recording happens in Flower Mound, which is about 3 to 3.5 hours, depending on traffic. So getting frosty like you do at the gym, yoga, all that, that's not really possible. It's mainly about trying not to be, for me anyway, trying not to be, to have that weird vacant road-worn feeling. Luckily, with this particular show, my guy is a man of few words. He doesn't raise his voice. He's super chill. I do have stuff that's higher energy that it's more difficult to get into, but this one in particular, it's relatively easy to kind of just fall into whatever happens. Mm-hmm. And I know I'm not going to be yelling. Whatever it is. Anyway. Oh,
so cool.
It's kind of interesting, too. I actually feel like once I started doing voice acting for a living, it actually changed, my personal life a little bit more because it becomes not just about, prepping for, I have one session later in the week that I need to be, on point for. It's, it becomes an everyday thing. And you really have to, protect your instrument. So I find I don't see live music as much anymore because trying to talk above the concert noise can wreck you for a session the next day.
Yeah, that's so true.
Or
anything with that. Or if you go on a roller coaster, don't scream when you're on it.
I'll actually try to stack that's sessions alarming. To use the sessions from one particular show, where I know if I've got something that's particularly deep and gravelly, I'll try to put that at the end of the week.
Yeah.
And that way I get through all this other stuff and it actually kind of warms me up and preps me and hurts my voice a little bit to the point, and this is probably not the way to do it safely, but hurts me to the point that I can get into that deep gravelly thing by the end of the week, and it's much more naturally there for me. And then, it gradually goes away over the course of the weekend, if you're lucky.
Yeah.
Sometimes you just
I like the tag on if you're lucky.
Gotta be lucky.
Yeah, if I'm voicing a boy character, it's very helpful if I happen to have a sore throat.
Oh, yeah.
That's what I'm talking about.
Or if you just wake up in the morning.
That's what I mean.
Liz.
Yeah.